हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ सतीश परयानी वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल वॉल्चन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द कंसेप्ट ऑफ आउटसोर्सिंग। लर्निंग आउटकम एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन एंड अप्लाई द स्ट्रैटेजिक टूल विच इज़ कॉल्ड आउटसोर्सिंग, एज आउटसोर्सिंग इज़ वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट एंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टूल फॉर एंटरप्रेनर्स एंड एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। What contents we will be covering in this session? First, what is nature of outsourcing? What are examples of outsourcing? Benefits of outsourcing? And what are the problems associated with the outsourcing? And what are the key references? First and foremost, we will go with the introduction. Outsourcing is the contracting of facilities that need to be undertaken on regular basis and which otherwise would be conducted within an organization. The term outsourcing is also sometimes used to describe the heaving of the activities from one country to another or from one place to another. This is most precisely called of offshoring and does not necessarily involve contracting out activities to another organization. Let us see first some examples, then we will discuss the outsourcing. Today, the big companies, Daimler, Chrysler, Ford, General Motors, mostly design and assemble vehicles, and their suppliers mostly make what goes into them. It has been observed that about 2/3 of the North America auto industry, $750 billion in value, now resides with the supplier. Means, I've personally seen one of the examples of big FMCG company, which is known as in India, LG Electronics, had done a lot of outsourcing activities major because of the reason that there is a peak or sudden demand during the seasonal times. And many times the capacity falls short. So they cannot build the capacity only for seasonal item or some limited period of time. So they decided to go for outsourcing. Support functions also have the outsourcing activity like HRM. Many aspects of HR has been outsourced. Selection, payroll, administration, development, career management, relocation. And one more important, what I have seen outsourcing activities is the training, the HR training, generally it is outsourced. Now we can see the companies like Infosys, TCS, Tech Mahindra, they outsource the activities of the hiring of freshers. First they conduct the test. For the test to conduct, they hire some organization so that they can conduct on the basis, the test on the basis of logical reasoning, then aptitude, then what you can say, different types of what they feel are important technical rounds, then they finally their management, their employees take the decision whether to hire or not. So first initial phase it has been outsourced. I have told you now companies Infosys, Tech Mahindra, now think of one manufacturing, one Indian company which has done outsource in the past. And what are the activities which they have done? Think it. You must have read in some paper. Now some other examples which I will say about outsourcing is Cisco Systems. Cisco Systems, tightly coordinated value chain network of manufacturers, subcontractors and resource planners. These are one of the biggest advantage with the Cisco Systems. General Electric has moved many manufacturing operations to countries like China, has outsourced important support activities especially to India. Not, and also we have seen General Electric, see now the big company like General Electric, they have moved manufacturing operation to China, they have moved some support activities to India. Now Indian also General Motors or General Electric, they do outsource activity within the country now. They can do outsourcing activity from General Electric Bangalore, we can say to, they can do it to Pune-based some suppliers. Now we'll discuss what are the benefits, why outsourcing activities is being carried out. First and foremost, the most important is they permit concentration of what an organization does best. Suppose the organization is having some core function of core manufacturing or core product from which they do not want to go out. So if some other marketing people ask demand, some other, so let us say the example of refrigerator, an organization is dealing with high kind of refrigerators. Now there is a certain demand after COVID, we can say a limited variety or small liter capacity of refrigerator will be manufactured, as they are sticking basically to the big refrigerators. So they do not, and on the second hand, they do not want to lose market of the small liters product, so they can outsource this activity and they can put their concentration on the big liter refrigerators. Allow utilization of packed expertise available in the market. Many times we see, even we are very good at certain, but some other organization, some other factory is good at some. So there is some expertise available. So we can use their expertise, we can use their knowledge, skills, and we can go for outsourcing. We cannot have everything in our organization. Somebody is good at forging, somebody is good at assembly of bolts, nuts, manufacturing. So they can go ahead with that. Now, the third most important is, can offer significant, often immediate cost saving, because they are into that business. Let us take the example of packaging industry. We cannot have the packaging full setup in our factory. So we can take the product from them. So we can reduce our inventory, we can see our overheads, we can see, and we can concentrate, as we said, on the main, our main strong product. The most organization these days think that they want to be more away from operational headaches. What not is required in organization when it have to be run? So many times, if the new product they want to launch, and if the trading kind of thing is done, or trading what you can outsourcing kind can help them, so they can just outsource that, take it and marketing this. We have seen the examples of outsourcing from big companies like Samsung, big companies like Apple, big companies like General Motors, big companies like Ford. They do certain operations as part of outsourcing. The most, again, important is avoids problematic labor relation and managerial deficiency. We have seen many times read in the past in the newspapers that outsourcing activities helped to reduce the labor headaches. Now, when there is any pandemic situation, the labors are out, the inventory issues, the labor issues are managed by that company, not your core organization. So labor relations, labor problems, labor everything can be, is one of the solution to get it done outsourced. The most, again, important is assets downsounding and delayering. Means we are not going for investment in assets. So this is one of the important benefit. Now let us see what are the problems faced by outsourcing. These are the certain problems like loss of key skills and competencies. Many times we outsource, we lose certain skills and we lose to competencies. Maybe that supplier, outsource supplier, can give our certain designs, certain our processes to other our competitors. So there is unreliability of suppliers, the writing of poor contract can be, they can use that. Loss of employee morale because our employee thinks that they are outsourcing, they can fire us. Communication problems during outsourcing, losing control over outsource activity because quality generally, if it is front of us, we can control. If it's outside, it cannot be controlled. Squeezing suppliers too hard, suppliers' exploration of dependency on them. So these are the major problems associated with outsourcing. What are the key references? The key references were used from MTPL and SlideShare Nets and the book Project Management and Control. From there we got a very important concept of outsourcing. Thank you, everybody.